conservation, increase in awareness, and cleanliness all lead way towards promoting tourism. The forts of Mumbai, we have all been to the forts, and we found that these forts are not lacking anything. They just need recognition. And if they're recognized, they can become, believe me, hot tourist spots. They have a lot of potential. But since there is nothing being done towards it, they're just lying in sad state of neglect. A simple thing to begin with, there are Mumbai Darshan tours all over the South Mumbai area. If these tours are specially designed for forts of Mumbai, it will be very beneficial for the tourists and the forts. If the tourists themselves are not told about the existence of these forts, if the tour guide doesn't tell them that there is such and such fort located in the area you're visiting, then there is no... they themselves cannot easily find out that such forts are there. So Mumbai Darshan is just our suggestion to include forts in various tourism tours. Coming to improving connectivity. The Green Voyagers, in the past few months, we visited each and every fort. And the most important problem that we faced was reaching the forts. We found out the area from Google Map and everything, but then when we used to ask the taxi walas and rickshaw walas to drop us there, they used to simply refuse. They used to say, we don't know. So we had to get down, walk, find out, ask people. They're like, we don't know. Until we reach like few meters towards the fort, then people used to say, okay, yes, the fort is there. So that is the basic problem. People don't know where the forts are. It's just there on the maps. It's just there, okay, the fort is located in Siuri, Sion. But then we really don't know how to get there. There are no buses. The taxis would refuse to go into that lane. Bandra and Sion, though, are locally very, very well known. So it is easier to get there. But the rest of the forts, it's a pain to find them out. So connecting those main roads to these forts is the government's responsibility. Also, it should also eradicate any misconceptions. What we came across was that Dharavi, being a slum, we were told that it's a dangerous area, don't go there alone. But then we need to go and find out what this is. We went there and we were surprised that the locals were very helpful. They were the ones who took us to the fort. They were actually living around it. So they knew quite a lot about it. They talked to us about how they feel living around the fort. They told us information about how the garbage is eroding the walls of the fort and things like that. And another fort I would like to mention was when we went to Siuri, the lane leading to the fort seemed quite deserted, dirty, and insecure. If we were actually tourists, we would feel really, the forts would feel unwelcoming to us. So what I'm getting at is lack of connectivity is the main cause of lack of information. If the government does nothing about giving directions to these forts while they're creating awareness about its existence, then even if there is clean forts, even if there are awareness, people would just go like, I don't know where the fort is, I'm not wasting time going there. So connectivity should and must be improved as soon as possible. As we saw in case of Bandra, cultural events Bandra provides a good space for cultural events. There's a proper amphitheater right beside the walls of the fort. This can also be used in other forts. I'm not saying all these forts are open for cultural events because some forts are actually falling. The walls are very dangerous. We really don't want to spoil them further by having a crowd inside the fort walls. But forts which are restored, like Varli and Siuri, they have some space inside them. These forts can be used for cultural events. And by cultural events, they can actually concentrate on promoting the forts themselves. The presentations about Mumbai's history, student tours, and things like that can happen in these forts. But again, we must make sure that no harm comes to the structure of the fort, because that is our first and foremost aim, not to spoil the structure of the fort. They're already in a very sorry state. Like Sion, it has set an excellent example of the forts being used as public spaces. Reading libraries, sitting areas. The forts, being coastal forts, offer a very, very beautiful view. So if proper benches are made, if there is good water facilities available, the youth can go there, sit and study. Nowadays, only Asiatic libraries are used by the youth for studying when there is no electricity at their place. Such forts can also be made available to them for their studying hours and reading and hanging out together and things like that. This way, tourism can be promoted and all the forts can be collectively promoted under the banner of Forts of Mumbai. while we're talking about the forts as one, we cannot ignore that all these forts have their own specific importance and significance. Each fort is different and each fort can be used differently. And this has already has begun, but the process needs to take pace. So I would like to address the forts individually for their for things that can take place there. Worli and Siuri forts first. Since they are comparatively well-maintained, clean, spacious, then these forts can be focused for becoming tourist hubs. If these forts are promoted as good picnic spots, if the connectivity is improved, if the godowns in Siuri, which are used for gambling and things like that, are cleaned up, if the security is increased, people would love to go there. If the view it offers is really, really good. Siuri ecotourism is increasing day by day. People are becoming more aware about the nature. So the forts can be used for this. Again, here, the government will have to provide tourist-friendly infrastructure, public toilets, water, even food stalls, not inside the fort, but at least outside in the area, so that people can use this as a holiday spot, can use this as a weekend spot. Students would love to do that. I'm telling you, my experience, we would really love to go there and hang out again. Sion Fort. Sion Fort, as you can see, is in a really pathetic condition. It is really sad. The fort actually looks like a fort when you go there, because all the other forts of Mumbai have, it's just a wall that is left. So Sion Fort, you can actually see, actually go and imagine how the forts, how the rooms must have been. So if the government takes up an urgent restoration work of this fort, this also has a huge potential to attract tourists. The people who are sitting in the garden underneath the fort would want to go climb up the stairs and visit the fort there. Many of the people who come in, the students from the school, SIES college that is near Sion, they come there, study, but they never pay attention to the fort that is above there. So if the Archaeological Survey of India tries their level best to restore this fort, make it safer for the tourists, then it will, and I'm sure will become a proper tourist spot. As in case of Dharavi Fort, it is sadly the most neglected fort. It is inside the Dharavi slums. People should forget that the Dharavi slums are dangerous. It is not. The locals are very helpful. If the fort is cleaned, if the locals are encouraged to help the tourists out, then again Dharavi can also be included in the list of tourist places. Coming to Bandra and Mahim forts, Bandra fort can be taken as a good example. The locals, the Bandstand residents, have done a very, very good job of maintaining this fort. Even though there are some hooligans there, the cleanliness, the restoration work has been very, very well done. So taking example of this, Mahim Fort, the residents in and around the fort can also be encouraged to help out the government in maintaining the fort. The youth, when we went there, we talked to the people living inside the fort, and then there were some people who were ready to tell us about what they think about the fort. So if these people are educated, if they are made aware of the heritage that they are living in, if they start feeling pride, taking pride in it, then they can help the government out in maintaining these forts. The government should give incentives to these people to become tourist guides. This will generate employment for the people living there, and this will help the government out. Nobody will point a finger to them and then tell them that they need to be evicted. Rehabilitation, yes, but then if at all, you can at least start by making the people living there understand about the history that they're living in. If they appreciate it, if the government appreciate it, then people would be more and more willing to visit those places. These have been just our suggestions, small suggestions, to actually begin the process of conservation of the forts of Mumbai collectively. If these suggestions will remain merely suggestions if they do not receive any political or administrative backing. All the citizens can do is go there, visit, spread awareness about them, take up cleanup drives, but how much can they do? The government needs to step in somewhere and give support to us and the citizens. So political backing, political will is a must to maintain these forts. What the aim of this whole project is, if we want to make sure that there is a balance between heritage and the modern city that Mumbai has become now. These structures, these icons are the symbol of the rapid growth that this city has witnessed till now. I feel since within 7 years, the city has changed tremendously. So we just want to create a balance. We don't want the modernization to be lost. We don't want the heritage to be lost. And this can be done. We are not, it is actually possible. So the aim of the project is making the forts a symbol of the past, the present, and even and possibly the future. So this is what we would like to tell you. Create awareness, spread awareness, talk about the forts, visit the forts. They are wonderful, and conserve the forts. Thank you very much.
Historians in the making. I disagree. I think they're already full-blown historians and public activists as well. I invite them to take some questions from the audience now. If you have a question, please raise your hands. I'll get the mic. Please wait for the mic because we're recording this entire event.
Thank you and congratulate you on bringing the forts to us, making them alive for us. I've been involved with conservation, but of nature, with the Bombay Natural History Society for 30 years or more. I would suggest that one of the ways is to team up, for instance, the Sivri one. Go and talk to the BNHS director, the PR person, so that whatever is done is ecologically sound. For instance, the plants that are planted, if one does it. One can do it also very creatively. Plants that attract butterflies, plants that attract birds, local plants, plants that were part of Bombay's heritage, Mumbai's heritage. So I would suggest, INTAC, of course, is another organization with which you can tie up, the Prince of Wales Museum. The idea of really of making these part of Mumbai's public spaces, which is wonderful. I went to Persepolis, for instance, the sound and light show over there made the whole place alive. Delhi Fort has a similar thing. So I think the possibilities are enormous, and I think you've planted a seed. Now you're going to nurture it, and all the very best.
Thank you, sir. It's like VT station has been declared under UNESCO as a protected area. And there was one point.
It's on.
There was point that railway board wanted to develop about 20 to 30 acres, the land near Wadi Bandar. And that was turned down to make a hotel and all those things. And now they are coming at this side of the fort, that is Bazaar Gate Street. There they have some land. So about 22 acres. So that is also turned down by UNESCO, that is United Nations Education. So if they could turn down and to make it as a monumental protected area, VT station, world class, which railway wanted, board wanted to do some play a dirty mischief with that, but it was not allowed, worldwide authority. Second, now UNESCO is going to declare Oval as a protected area. That is also going on. Third, even Marine Drive. So if you could take help of UNESCO and declare all the forts as a protected area, so all our problems will be solved, budgeting, tourism, everything. There is no need for any, and it will be one of the very good things. I think UNESCO help we should take if you want to save Bombay. And second point, as far as Dharavi, Sivri Fort goes, MMRDA wants to develop that, wants to make that bridge connecting, so that flamingos will go away. So ultimately it will affect that. So if UNESCO comes into picture, this will be all, there will be caps on that. So it will be a very good thing if you could take over with UNESCO. I don't know the procedure, what it is, but if Oval and VT can be saved, I think all these open spaces can be saved, and we won't have any budget problems, gambling, all, whatever this.
But the problem is not all that very easy. It's quite complex.
Now we have to start. If VT could be done in a span of 5 years, even all the forts Bombay could, and Bombay requires UNESCO. Bombay will not be, it will be very difficult to maintain all these heritage structures. Okay. This is my suggestion.
Sir, the problem that you're addressing is a common one, not only for Mumbai, but in a lot of parts of India face that. And the basic problem is not about budgeting, it's about political will. If we want to conserve the forts, we do not require someone to come and tell us that this is a World Heritage Spot. That is a very big benefit. But what we really require is political will. Now, political will is something that governance will give us, but at the same time, it is something that has to come from the citizens.
The Mahim problem, the Mahim fort, it's a real complex problem. There are a lot of encroachment and the whole issue is a legal issue.
But
it becomes a social issue also. What do you do the people staying over there within the fort? But there will be a lot of social protest. It's not going to, it's not all that easy at
So they can give them alternative accommodation.
They are very, very interactive. They are very reluctant to leave the place. They are very reluctant. No, they are.
I think the problem here that we're facing is basically there is a basic confusion about what needs to be done. What needs to be done is basically conserve the forts. The fact that governmental bodies are fighting amongst themselves is indicative of lack of political will. If people themselves are not aware, then it is the duty of the government to make us aware. If the government is more concerned about, you know, settling their interdepartmental problems, then obviously what sir said was right. We're going to lose the fort in that process. What we need is a clear-cut plan of action to conserve the forts in a way that is socially equitable and which does not compromise on our heritage, because both of these are equally important. So,
yes.
Thank you.
Ma'am, just one suggestion for students of our college and also other colleges. Like, you have introduced the heritage management course, and we can introduce in other colleges also. I mean, we as students will also be very excited to go to these forts. I mean, it will be a nice thing. And we did not know about these forts before. I mean, today we came to know that, okay, there are so many forts.
Yeah, agreed that we have recently started heritage management course for the students of Ruya in Mumbai. But the response is so overwhelming that we really don't have a chance to, you know, take it to the other colleges. So we don't publicize it. But certainly we'll certainly take your request and certainly try to, as a part of the heritage course, we certainly take that. These students now who are well versed can be a part of this heritage walks to Mumbai. We'll certainly take into consideration.
Hi, good evening. My name is Delia and I come from Warsaw in Andheri. History has been my passion, so I was just eager to hear about the history of the Mumbai forts. I've read about history, and the Mumbai of history that all of us know is limited, you know, to the Portuguese or the British rule. But Mumbai has been in existence even much before that, because of the, you know, we've seen the there has been the Ashoka edict. Dynasty. There's an edict found in Sopara, Nala Sopara. And after that, then we had the Chalukya, the Maurya, the Rashtrakoot, the ones who built the Elephanta caves. Yeah, and the latest, so just before the Portuguese came in, that was sometime around the 16th century, just before that, there has been Raja Bimbadev, you know, who has established Mahikavati. So he was the founder of Mumbai in the real sense. Why is it that you do not see any forts constructed by these dynasties, and why is it that we see only forts constructed by Portuguese or the British?
Okay.
Yeah, or could it also be, you know, that, you know, just like, you know, the British had, you know, they had a tendency of actually taking over some of the original structures and then making it look as if it was theirs. You know, so that's what they did to the Mandapeshwar caves in Borivali. So I just wanted to hear more about, you know, what are your views on the original forts of Mumbai. Thank you.
This is true that Bombay was an important trade center in the medieval period, and the Bim dynasty that you mentioned has been... In fact, it did build, Pratap Bim built the Mahim Fort.
We didn't mention about it.
Yeah, and we have mentioned that it is the oldest fort
in Mumbai.
And when you talk about why the concentration comes to the European powers in Bombay, it's because we can truly give them the credit to recognize the potential of Bombay. What was just considered as a group of stray islands was given a tangible shape of a city. And it happened only with the transfer of power to the British. And during our research, we found out that most forts were built by the Portuguese, which were later on taken over by the British. So you can't really say that we are laying stress on a particular power, but the facts are in front of us that the potential was realized by the European powers. Yeah.
And we did mention about the ancient fort that is built by Bhim Deva, that is at Mahim, and way back in the 12th century. I think so, it must have come late, but we didn't mention and recognize that. Right in the beginning, I must have missed the earlier part of the presentation.
I did mention about one of the ancient forts, Bhim Deva. It was renovated by the British, and the present structure, I have to research on this, of course, but I do not think it is the original structure of the Mahim Fort. It must have been altered. In fact, the architecture clearly...
Most of the place has been altered and undergone a lot of renovation.
And it has inscriptions from in the Roman script. So it was restored by the British.
Put references, you know, where I can get information, because I really want to study the Mumbai forts and all the ancient...
We have the slides. We referred to a book by B.V. Kulkarni. It's written in Marathi, Mumbai Parisaratil Kille.
Srivastava's book also on maritime forts of Mumbai.
Yeah.
Of Mumbai.
So there are two or three books which have been the main references.
Regional sources. Balchandra Kulkarni has the book on forts of Mumbai.
Get the reference to the Mahim forts originally.
Yes.
Thank you.
All the details.
Hello. Thank you, Ma'am Louisa, and your students. I was very much enlightened with your lecture, and I'm sure everybody here was also. And I have been a teacher in school, and as a part of the excursion trips we do have in schools, you just said that people should be enlightened, people should go and visit the forts. But there is a loss of connectivity. But then as part of the excursion trip, if we do want to take our students to, like, we want them to know the forts of Mumbai, how do we take them, if we want to take them? Yeah, that was the lecture was all about. But then if we want to, like she said, they should know, people should go there.
Since we have visited all these forts and we did have the problem locating these forts, we don't mind taking the initiative of, you know, accompanying your students and maybe directing or maybe some sort of direction that we can give you, or maybe draw maps saying that how to connect. So the lack of connectivity, we can draw it for you all, and certainly
I would like
benefit.
To inform you, I'm from Bhabha Atomic Research Center.
Okay. Bhabha. Okay, sure.
Ma'am, another thing you can do is, instead of targeting forts which are somewhat unsafe, there are some forts which are completely accessible. Like, if you first decide to go to Bandra and Sion, the original structure is visible here. So if you want to talk about the historical aspect, that is truly there. And when that kind of interest builds, we will be completely...
Even Varli Fort is quite safe. You can take the student and it's well maintained. And there
Varli,
are locals...
Varli, Bandra and Varli, Sion.
Yes, Varli, Bandra and Sion.
And as we arranged it, I do contact you to take them.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thank you so much.
You're most welcome.
It was very interesting, because last 60 years I didn't know that there were ports. In port also I couldn't see any port. And today I invited my daughter also, that there were some ports here. What I say that the whole face of Bombay is changing. By the builders are there, they can have some little corporate social responsibility.
Yes, absolutely.
Can't they do that? Like Dharavi, they want to make Dharavi a Shanghai, maybe, I don't know. With a concrete jungle, they will lose all these things. But then they can do this, take up this, and why you cannot tell these builders?
There are museums which are being, you know, restored and established, Bahudaji Land Museum, by these corporate worlds.
Yeah.
So this initiative can be taken certainly by them.
And they got the money. They do not know what to do with that money, with the corporate social responsibility.
So certainly we should really...
And Dharavi is going for a makeover.
Yes, absolutely.
In this makeover, they should not lose this... whatever is remaining there, it should not get bogged down with all these developments, concrete jungles, etc. Why don't you make this, I mean, represent the government? They got corporate social responsibility, they can take it over immediately. Yes. That Bombay First or what that society is there, they're talking about McKinsey reports, they're talking about ringing rounds and all that. Why not they have connectivity with this?
Yeah, surely, surely.
They have come out with the tender in papers, maybe sector 5 or something, and the port is near them. So if you can approach MADA and for this some conditions we can keep for this port, Dharavi port, like routes accessible to be made, you know, and MADA will be glad to do it. MADA is doing, we need not bother of builders, MADA is a government agency, they are going to do sector 5 and port is there. Tender they have come out for development of Dharavi.
Good evening. I'm a student. My name is Kushbu Mishra. The presentation was really very beautiful. I'm staying here in Mumbai for say past 20 years, and me being of this generation, I move a lot. But I absolutely had no idea about the forts of Mumbai and their conditions. So what I suggest is the first thing or the first step is acceptance. Acceptance of the fact that there are forts and their condition is like this. And we, being the product of the environment, we have the responsibility to actually save the environment around us. Now, when you talk about media and spreading awareness, I believe media and journalism, we don't deny the fact that they actually do a lot of work. But then it is a failure if it doesn't really reach out everywhere. Or it doesn't really connect people. Because me staying over here for 20 years, I absolutely don't remember reading anything about it, mm-hmm. or rather seeing anything about it on TV or commercials or whatever. So basically what I suggest is first step is acceptance that somewhere we are responsible for it and we have the responsibility to actually look forward to making it a better tomorrow, and nextly spreading awareness, of course, and then taking up some steps. For conserving it. Thank you. Thank you.
Since she just mentioned that acceptance is the first step towards conservation, I'd like to quote the incidents when we were talking to an official source. I will not name the source on his express instructions that I do not name him. But he was a government official and I do not want to mention that he is in a state of denial, but from my point of view, it looked like he was in a complete denial of the fact that the forts are not conserved. Even if they have been restored, they have not been restored properly. And there's this general lack of awareness among the authority. So I think awareness, citizen awareness, is a secondary issue. When it comes to acceptance, as Khushbu mentioned, even the authorities need to be made aware that the work that they're doing is not really commendable.
So we went through various maps of Mumbai, and all these forts have been mentioned there, have been put on a tiny, tiny spot. The Sion Fort, Dharavi, Bandra, these forts have been mentioned there, but then they're so small, they just, we don't even notice them.
No, but we can make an effort to...
Definitely, yes. We are planning to come up with our publication about these, and we definitely would put all these suggestions, maps, and the way to reach these connectivity, definitely.
The location, how to
yes.
go there. Yeah, certainly.
Myself, Hina Sheikh, and I'm student of Ruya College. So I just want to give a suggestion because you all are perfect in your presentation.
Thank you.
And I don't want to point out. And my suggestion is this, that every year, all colleges are invited or by others college in the events. Like we have Elixir, Raj Tarangani. So why we should, we can promote this force of Mumbai. In our events, okay? So that other students coming from a different college, they can have an idea because our youth are very glorious and they can have a very, they are very encouragement. So,
I would like to answer this.
we are recently trying to come up with an exhibition of the forts. The History Department is planning to organize a national seminar on 15th of September, and the topic would be emergence and growth of the cities in Mumbai, historical perspective. On that day, we are planning to certainly have an exhibition. In fact, Alisha Siddiqot, who is trained in museology in London, she'll be in fact training our students how to exhibit. So after the training that they receive, we are certainly coming up with an exhibition on the force. It will be certainly displayed. And we'll certainly, we have on our website, we have the Facebook, the Green Voyagers. If you go on, just click Green Voyagers, it's comprised of 10 students. So we'll have the page in the wall page. We will just put up an update. So we'll certainly take into consideration and Green Voyagers, yeah. So we will now take it seriously and update everything. Yes, we have to, you know, taking up this particular project does involve a lot of finance, and so far, though we have approached, we're very reluctant, we have not really got response, so it's entirely our own funding, and even when it comes to publication, we certainly require a lot of funding, because we did send a professional photographer, because we need to have a professional photographer taking the 300 DPI resolution, which is quite expensive. So we are looking forward for funding as far as our project is concerned. Then we'll be able to exhibit, and then, so any in this context, if anybody really wants to help us, do contact us.
We will definitely support you if you will become such a good person.
Thank you. I would like to add something to what Hina said. Being from the same college, we do have a lot of events, departmental events and all. But how we came to know about the existence of this forts were way back in our first year. We were introduced to a new paper in history on Mumbai. That is the first time we came to know, okay, there are forts in Mumbai. If such things are not mentioned in our curriculum, there is a very remote possibility of us coming to know about students, as students who come to know about these forts. So it was actually very good for us that we had that paper. We got to learn the history of Mumbai itself, and that is how we came to know about forts. If that paper is continued, more and more students will start coming to know about this, and they will probably join Green Voyages with us.
I have a couple of observations. I just want to,
For the publication, that is our next step. We have to go sort of fully read the gazetteers. The information, yes, it's all of them. All the references that we have referred to now have mention of the gazetteers.
Hi, I'm Gautam Kirtane, I'm with the ORF. So that point is something I was just going to bring up for discussion, is the way we study our history is terrible in a lot of ways. And we seldom study the history of Mumbai. And the history of Mumbai that we do study is British, and before that, Portuguese. I think everybody knows about Catherine of Braganza. And I think it's a story told over and over and over again. But what happened before that, you know, from the time of Ashoka, Kanheri Caves were first established, and then these forts were established. And a lot of history of Mumbai was actually not fought in the island city. It was between the Salsette Islands and the city of Mumbai, the seven islands. So where your Rewa Fort and Mahim Fort and Bandra Fort and Sion Fort are. So just rewriting history in a very interesting way, and it shouldn't be at a college level when you're FIJC or SYJC. I think it should be at a much earlier level when we first get introduced to history.
Yes.
So that's one observation. I think we really desperately need to rewrite it in a nice, fun, interesting way with field visits. It should be part of curriculum.
Yes.
Also, I don't think that, you know, Mumbai deserves a museum about its own history and culture. You know, Mumbai's history and culture is so rich. And it's so old, you know, one of the oldest cities and ports, and we really don't do much about it. We have museums which speak of so many other things from all around the world, you know. Our Prince of Wales has such beautiful artifacts from Harappa, Mohenjo-Daro also, but we need a museum which is dedicated to Mumbai. I think that will really bring about a change, not only for forts, but maybe also for bazaars and little things that are cultural.
It's so rich. It's
not
so
just
rich.
Physical, but also cultural. And I had one more suggestion. No, one is I don't agree with your idea fully of of kind of integrating people who have encroached on these structures. If you see the Mahim Fort, and you have seen the Mahim Fort, it's pathetic. You can't, if you're well nourished, you can't enter the Mahim Fort because that entrance is so narrow.
Yes, you have to
literally that you can't enter.
Yeah, you just can't enter.
So why would you promote them? I mean, they're people who have encroached your... It's. I'm sorry, you just got to drive them out. I mean, plain and simple. And finally...
No, is it very easy? Yes. It's so complex, the problem.
I never said it was easy. I never said. I just said there's no need to have the sympathy and make them stakeholders and stuff.
There's so many people standing against you.
You just push them out. Like, get out, we'll figure you out later.
You can't. That cannot be a solution.
We're talking about the people who have encroached on Mahim Fort.
Yes.
The problem, there are so many aspects to the problem. Yes, it's a fort. Yes, it's our heritage. But this is also where these people live. It is because these people have been ignored to such an extent that they are forced to use these forts as their home. So it's not restricted to Mahim Fort alone. Mumbai is overtaken by these slums. And eviction, rehabilitation, and basically setting these people up for a better life. All
set
of these,
them up for a better life.
So all of these require, again, basically...
Political will,
exactly. Political will and,
administrative backing also. Administrative backing also is required. You know, it's not all that very easy to see and perceive.
The next plot to this fort can be developed as a resident FSI could be 2.5 and they can be given back.
No, but then there are CRZ regulations.
Just want to, Ketan. Just want to add a small thing. You just mentioned about Mumbai's museum. I think there is a well-maintained museum is already exist in Mumbai, which was established in 1865, and which is well-maintained by the BMC. So Ketan, you should know, I think you should love to visit Baudajillar Museum.
We have visited Baudajillar.
And it's well-maintained museum dedicated to the Mumbai city only.
Absolutely. I'm aware of it. No, we have BST Museum also. If you go to the BST Museum. Yes.
I think I'd like to, please, with your indulgence,
Lena, one
thing.
Lena, just let me add one thing. I come from a city which is a living fort. This is Jaisalmer. And this person should visit that place to see how those persons are staying over there, to understand how they can maintain their heritage. This is the only fort which everybody lives, including myself.
Correct. Okay, thank you. I'm sure they will stay on to talk to you all privately, but I think before we lose most of our audience, I'd like to be able to thank them and close the formal part of this evening. Please feel free to stay on and interact. I think two messages came out very clearly, that we as citizens of Mumbai also have a responsibility to participate in keeping our cultural treasures alive. We at the ORF are going to, this is the first step, we are going to look at how we can help, young India actually stand up for its rights and its heritage. Thank you all. Please join me in thanking them so much. Your passion, your interest, and your thing has been very catching. We are all going back very hopeful, and we will in the coming months we will work together to reach these voices to the government. It is true, it is difficult and challenging, but we are a public policy think tank, and we do know how to approach government and look for opportunities, and we will do that in the coming months together. Thank you all again very much.
Thank you.